No way! Finally, I get to see this guy!
Low power mode.
I've been all around the world.
It's only $31!
Jeez, you put that mustache.
No, it's only
every place. Always been a restless girl. But now there's a window change.
For anybody, cool. You know, 67 miles per hour and a, you know, 4-ton bad guy right here, right? She's like, no, I would not like to be the person run over by 4.2 tons.
She likes all of her toes where they are right now.
Yeah, they look nice in the shoes. It's better than that. But you know, why don't we go over there? I'm gonna get right over there to the short wall over there. That's okay. Probably a good spot.
Yeah.
I'm gonna walk right across through here. Now, if you just don't mind listening to my wonderful reasons, assistant, I greatly appreciate it. You're gonna make sure you stay out of harm's way.
I'm one of the top ecologists here for the PCI, which stands for the Pandora Conservation Initiative. And over the hours, we are a team of scientists, engineers, and ecologists, and basically,
yeah.
And that's what we call job security. Now, as I said, we are a team, and of course, I got my right-hand man. This latest thing is we added a cup holder. Look at that! That guy's like, whoa, that's such a great idea! See, you would have thought about you in Italy, and you could get up your company and impressing everybody with your great knowledge about Pandora. Matter of fact, I think that's what you should do right now. Would you like to impress people with your knowledge of Pandora? Here, come right up here, sir. Yes, you. The glass. Yeah, come right up here.
Oh.
My buddy, what's your name?
Jonathan Smith.
No way. His name is John Smith. You gotta be kidding me. You know what? I love that. I love it, Jonathan. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and the audience here, and I need to make sure I find someone of your intellectual prowess. Someone I think is your intellectual match. And it's going to be... How are you doing, Minnie Mouse? Do you want to come play a game with us?
Oh.
No? How about you, buddy? You want to play here? Come over here.
Over here.
All right, now, guys, I don't know if you know this, but we're about to play the most exciting game here in Pandora. It's called Pandora Trivia! Woo! How this is going to work is I'm going to talk to my man here to ask Mr. John Smith one question, and then I'm going to ask you a question. What's your name, buddy?
It's my buddy, Logan.
Logan! How you doing, buddy? How you doing? Now, I'm going to ask you very difficult questions, and then we're going to see who gets the most right. Whoever gets the most right is going to be our Pandora genius of the day.
We're struggling with a little bit of support. Probably smoke the crowd up in the tour.
I guess we can do that. You know what? All right, let's do that. So let's go right down the middle. If you want to be on John Smith's team, go right over on this side.
Oh, everybody wants to lay.
Turn around. Look at your team. Everybody, isn't he awesome looking? You definitely look at this guy's team.
Come to me, I'll tell you.
Yeah, Logan! Are you ready for this? Now, Logan, since I think you're a little younger, I'll start with you, okay? Now, these questions are very, very technical, so listen, you get it. Here's your first question. Right now, you are on the moon of Pandora. Can you say that? Can you say the moon of Pandora? All right. So is the moon of Pandora a moon or a planet? The moon of Pandora. What do you think it is? The moon of Pandora, is it a moon or a planet? I think I couldn't hear what he said. Is it the moon of Pandora? Now, if you want, you turn around.
Anybody on your team can also help out and get the correct answer. If you think about it,
the moon of Pandora,
and you're right. Is it a moon or a planet?
Is that your final answer? He keeps saying planet.
It's okay.
Emily, what was the final answer? What's your final answer?
Go ahead.
Okay,
one,
he just changed it.
Moon! That's correct! All right. All right, John. Now we got a question for you, big guy. Yes. Now, moons like orbit around planets, right?
Sure.
And of course, the planet the moon of Pandora orbits around is called?
Pandora planet?
Here we go. Next question. In the opposite solar system, where we are right now, there are three suns. There's Alpha Centauri A, Alpha Centauri B, and the third sun is called Alpha Centauri C. Oh my goodness, that is two for Logan, and you'll get there. Here we go. All right. All right, John, now I'm thinking about maybe you just know more stuff about Pandora. Like, you know more about things here, maybe not all things out there, right?
Sure.
So let's go ask this question. Now, if you ever got to go have you got a chance to go on Flight of Passage? No, no. Do you know what you get to ride on? You can ride on Mount Banshee, right?
Banshee, okay.
Right, thank you. So what is the Navi word for Mount Banshee? Go!
Akasho.
That far off is on the Ethereum, but I can't accept that answer. It's all right, but you were pretty good for just mumbling words. All right. All right. So, it's gonna get a little bit more difficult. Ready? Oh, you want to ask this one?
Oh, I got this one.
All right.
All right. Now, keep in mind, you can't use anybody on your team, so listen up, team. Here on Pandora, we have developed a program to allow us to blend in seamlessly with the Na'vi, the native people that live here, and require us to connect to these biomechanical blue suits. What is the name of that program?
Avatar.
Say it nice and loud, what's that? Avatar program! That's correct! Alright! That is three correct answers for you, my friend. And, you know what, John, I'm feeling a little
different.
I'm going to give you an easy question. And it's so easy because I've already given you the answer since I've been out here. Alright? So this one's not too bad. And it's one that, I mean, I know this answer about you, but my question to you is, John, what's my name?
It's like, somebody help him.
Now, wait, hold on. No! Logan, you know my name's Gary, right?
But,
no.
What's my name, Logan?
Gary!
Oh man, this guy is smart. You know what?
Follow up question for me, Mr. John.
Oh,
what's my name?
Alright.
There it is.
Alright.
Well, that gives you 3 points to know his name, but you got 6 points, and you are our trivia champion, so go ahead and kick in for the awesome. Congratulations, John. Just do me a favor. If you get a little lost, keep him around. He'll help your survival rate, for sure.
Absolutely.
Now, of course, one of these that helps me survive is this bad boy that I'm sitting in right now. It is called the Class 2 7600X. But there's a lot of syllables, so let's just call it the Utility Suit. And what I'm about to do is I'm about to give this Utility Suit a little stroll right down this way. So if you guys would like, get a little pat for me.
There you go.
Cool. Nice. So we go T-Logan over here, T-John over here, but everybody's going to be a winner because you're all going to see how cool I look when I walk in this awesome suit. Yeah. Now, do we need to touch
that? Of course.
I don't know if there's time to have a nice little stroll. Do you want to go ahead and have Hana down for me?
Okay. Oh,
it's going to go behind the line. All the way behind the line.
This suit works for everybody. Yeah, yeah. Explain. You know what? I'll walk it. And you can talk. No, let's do it. That's absolutely true. Let me take off the parking brake here.
Drop that baby back in the gear.
Here we go. We are ready to go. Tell me when you're ready for me to strut.
Oh, sure. Wherever you are. Wherever you are. So, ladies and gentlemen, this seat revolves around what we refer to as a dynamic balancing system, or DBS for short. So it's very similar to a Segway or hoverboard, if you will. And whichever way we lean our bodies, the suit follows suit. And it goes along with us to make it a lot easier to get to our destination. So, when we lean our bodies ever so slightly forward, forward as it ensues, and then traveling happens. As you can see, nice and easily. Now, as you're going to see in a moment, the braking system is pure perfection, and boom, stops on a dime, as long as that dime is about 4 feet. And, yeah. Nice hit, Gary.
Yeah!
This is a great view for us in the mall, but you want to turn it around for a better view?
Oh, yeah. There we go. Over here. Now, guys, that was some pretty cool technology. If you guys like gather around, gather back around. We do have a program where you can buy one of these. If you guys have $4 billion cash right now, we can sell you one right now. And we've got $4 billion cash right now. $4 billion. If not, we have a 2-year-old who will make it piece by piece. That's $1.8 million. Once again, our HR department only takes cash only, though.
Yes.
$1.8 million? Okay. I wouldn't go with that.
Yeah, I know. Millionaires.
What I would like to do is maybe talk to you guys for a quick second about something you guys can do back at home to do the same things that we do here at the PCF. Now, this awesome machine helps me do a lot of great conservation work. But, you know, each of you can do a little something back on Earth to help Mother Nature. So, does any of you guys have a good idea of something you can do to help Mother Nature? What's something that helps planet Earth?
Yep.
Yes, sir. Raise your hand.
You're for helping.
Huh?
For helping.
He forgot you. I didn't forget. I asked you what can you do to help Mother Nature?
Recycle.
Recycle. That's a good one.
Yo, picking up trash.
Pick up trash. That's a great one. Actually, don't leave any trash. There's another one. Pick up, too.
Also, probably.
Grow plants.
Lucky, you are good. All the answers. You know what? I love this guy. So what I'm thinking is maybe each part you do a little something, and then you do a little something, and this big guy does something for us. Each of you do a little something. Collectively, you guys all make a very big difference back on Earth. All right? So I want to see you guys go make that big difference back on Earth. And that's a challenge that I have for you. So with the now you say we're going to challenge you today, see my code, which means we rise to the challenge. So everybody say, see my code.
See my code.
Yeah. So I want you guys to rise to that challenge. Go home, make that change. Can you guys do that for me?
I didn't hear.
Yes. Can you guys do that for me?
Yes.
I know a little bit more of you. You know what? Maybe you guys don't want me to say, yeah, maybe we get a nice little chant going. While I walk off into the sunset, I want to hear everybody say, Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co, come on.
Z-Va-Co,
Z-Va-Co,
Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co, Z-Va-Co.